But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Friends, welcome. Please be seated. I say again, friends, welcome, because these are two words that I think are just so very fitting when it comes to a celebration of life when we're talking about Doreen. Friends and welcome. This was a life worthy of celebration. It was a life full of friends and offering welcome. It's a celebration that we share because Doreen shared so much of her life with us. We might be inspired by other qualities of Doreen's life, her seeking out joy, her adventurous spirit, and yeah, we might even be able to celebrate just a little bit of her very, very competitive nature. We also might celebrate the promise that is in the reading that we heard just now from Isaiah chapter 40, that even though Doreen isn't here in person, God lifts her up on eagle's wings, that she is still able to run those races. Even though this is a celebration, we cannot escape the hard truth that whether you believe in an afterlife or not, we'd rather still have Doreen with us here in person in a way that is familiar. To hear another story and to see her smile. We therefore meet today with a sacred task. The task of caring for one another in the way that Doreen would have cared for us. If you are watching this service online as it is streaming into the world beyond this room, you can offer your prayers. If you are here in person, you can offer kind words and strong shoulders. After we leave the service here in this space, we will move over across the hall for a time of food and fellowship and more stories to share. That is part of the process that we move today, the process towards healing. And so I would invite you all to come across the hall. And for those of you who choose to, if you are brave enough to brave a Saskatchewan winter day, we will be having a very brief burial service at the cemetery south of town, Sunset Cemetery, after luncheon. And also helping us out today is the St. Andrew's Choir, which Doreen was a part of for all of her life. And so thank you very much for being here to help us with this celebration. Please join me in prayer. Holy God, into this life you invite us, and then you call us to far more than simple living. You call us to joy and a life of service to one another. You call us to seek out deep relationships and the beauty that you've embedded into your creation. We thank you for the gift of life found in the many days of Doreen. We thank you for the love she shared with her family, friends, and community. We thank you for the uniqueness of her character and the joy that she shared. Through all this, though, we ask that you lend us your strength and your comfort. The death of Doreen has left a hole in our hearts that needs mending. Be with us, therefore, and inspire us to offer your healing grace to those who knew her. In community, we pray. Amen. Doreen picked our hymns for today, and the first one is going to be sung by the St. Andrew's Choir, Old Rugged Cross.
Yeah.
When was the last time you were the recipient of a really good welcome? Like, I mean the kind of welcome that you get when they just cannot contain themselves just how happy they are to see you. You may have experienced this kind of welcome if you have come home to a loving pet, or maybe you've had this kind of welcome when you've gone off to see family that you haven't seen in a really long time. This kind of welcoming, this deep, heartfelt hospitality has always been a very, very big part of the Christian faith. Jesus always welcomed everybody. Didn't matter who you were, didn't matter if you were turned away by everybody else, didn't matter if you were poor or rich or powerful or outcast, didn't matter. If you wanted to be welcomed by Jesus, he was there to bring you into the fold. The only people actually Jesus ever turned away were those who could not accept his radical hospitality and love of everybody. One of the passages, a little known passage in the Bible that I just love, that talks about this is from the 13th chapter of Hebrews. It says, "Do not neglect to show hospitality to strangers, for by doing that, some have entertained angels without knowing it." Have entertained angels without knowing it. What a great idea. It calls us to a kind of spiritual imagination. That person at my door could be an angel. And so I had better treat that person as such. If you ever visited Doreen, there is a really good chance that you were treated like an angel. In the 9 years that I've known Doreen, I have been fed, I have been welcomed, and I have certainly been entertained by Doreen. She was a prairie storm of energy, and all of those winds blew in friendship. Every Sunday before church, the choir would meet for practice, and sometimes they'd actually get some singing in. Because right there in the middle of choir practice would be Doreen, sharing stories, telling people about what has happened in the past week, just making connections. Because that's the real reason to be in the choir, right? Singing is wonderful, but that's where your friends are. And she's going to take that moment to spend that time in conversation with her friends. And it was the same after church. If you went into the coffee time where we were having coffee and cookies, you would always see Doreen there at one of the tables holding court with a group of her friends, telling them stories about her past life on the farm. But if you actually approached her table looking like you might need to have a place to sit, she would give you the biggest smile, there would be a twinkle in her eye, and she'd be scooting her chair over so that you could sit right next to her, where she could grab onto your arm and tell you the most important story that you're ever going to hear. And outside the church, it was the same thing. Family gatherings where everybody who talked to Doreen was made to feel like they were welcomed and special. Last week I heard the story of somehow when you went to Christmas dinner, there'd be some guy there you didn't know. He just shows up. But that's somebody that Doreen met. And if she didn't invite him over for dinner, he'd be alone. And so that's never going to do. And so maybe in a miracle that might remind you of Jesus dividing the loaves and fishes to feed the multitudes, Doreen somehow squeezes one more chair into the tables in her home to feed one more lonely soul. And that, of course, brings us to her home. You might walk into her home and think, as I did the first time I was there, oh my goodness, what a lot of stuff. But it wasn't just stuff, was it? It wasn't the shelves filled to capacity, every horizontal spot piled up with things that she'd collected. It wasn't just the ceiling hanging everything from the ceiling everywhere you go. As a tall person, I found it actually a little bit terrifying. But if you got the tour and she told you about all these things, it was stories. That's what was all over the house. And it wasn't just the stories of where she had been, the adventures she's taken, but it was also the names. More importantly, it was the names. It was the name of the nephew that drove her down to Las Vegas to get this one thing that she'd found. It was the friend she made on the trip where she found this collectible. All of that stuff in her house, it wasn't just stuff. It was relationships. It was the things that drew her community into her own life. And of course, I have to mention, apparently there was a little bit of an omission in the obituary, and if we're talking about Doreen welcoming, I would be remiss in not mentioning a few family members that did not make it into the obituary, Raymond and Elva Wright. And rest assured, for all of those in the Wright clan, the obituary will be corrected. As I said earlier, hospitality is absolutely central to the Christian faith, and faith was so very important to Doreen. I don't know if she ever would have asked herself, should I welcome this person into my home or into my life because that's what Jesus would have done? I think more likely she was that welcoming, that hospitable, just because that's who she was. It's how she was raised, it's how she lived her life, it's how she found her joy. And so she just did that because it just seeped out of her soul. It's who she was. And if you are here, I'm going to bet that you've had a taste of that welcoming, that you have been touched by that depth of love and hospitality. And now maybe you're thinking that the world is just a little bit poorer a place because now she's gone. But you know, it doesn't have to be that way. Because to be very honest, the world still needs Doreens, or at least the people that are carrying on that legacy. Because when you look at the world around us, there are far too many of us that are focusing on the things that are angry or frightening. Too many people are searching out ways to feed their addictions of hatred and fear and cynicism. Things that Doreen did not share. I don't think I ever saw a cynical moment in her life that I had known her. And so we need people like Doreen to bring some joy into our life, to remind ourselves to give up on the narcissism. We need to be a community, people that welcome each other, people that take care of each other. But the good news is that you've all been taught. You've been taught by Doreen on how to do just that. And so, even though Doreen is gone, you can still hold on to a little piece of that in your hearts. That gift that she gave you, the gift that you can still carry on, the gift that when you fulfill in the lives of others, you will be drawing Doreen closer to your heart. And now you might be thinking, yeah, but it's so hard to do. You might think of excuses as to why we can't be so outgoing and kind and generous with those around us, because the world around us is just so difficult. Well, Doreen didn't always have an easier time either. She had difficulties in her life that she had to push through. And I know this because, well, there's a book. I recommend reading it. As you read it, imagine Doreen standing next to you, holding onto your arm, telling you these stories. Personally, I am so saddened to have to say goodbye to this dear friend. But I know that Doreen would want us to move beyond sadness to new life, to make a new friend, to run a new race. That's why I think it is so fitting that we end this message with a short poem that Tammy shared with me called Afterglow by Helen Lowry Marshall. I'd like the memory of me to be a happy one. I'd like to leave an afterglow of smiles when life is done. I'd like to leave an echo whispering softly down the ways of happy times and laughing times and bright and sunny days. I'd like the tears of those who grieve to dry before the sun of happy memories that I leave when life is done. Please join me in prayer. Holy God, into your world you breathe life, and as your Son Jesus says, we are to have that life in abundance. We thank you for the life of Doreen. Her friendship and her service to her community were an inspiration. The love she shared for her family and all of those she adopted as her own have been richly blessed. Inspire us to carry on her work, her fun, and even a bit of her competitiveness. May we hear your call to each and every one of us to love our neighbors as you have loved us. Let us celebrate that the stories of our lives have a chapter devoted to our time with Doreen. We also pray that you be a comfort to us in this time of pain. We pray especially for Doreen's family. We pray for her siblings as well as her nieces and nephews. We pray that the sadness that they feel now over what they've lost is quickly replaced with the joy over what they've been given. All this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. I'll invite you to join in singing in this next hymn. And after the hymn is over, I ask you to stay standing for our final blessing. Please stand as we sing together, Joyful, Joyful.
Other love is reigning over us. we're singing, march we onward, victors in the midst of strife. Joyful
music leads us onward in the
triumph
song of life.
Holy God, through the miracle of your grace, you give us life, and through the promises of Jesus, you promise us new life with you. May Doreen dwell forever in your care. May rest and fun and joy be with her always. Amen.
Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep smiling until then. Who cares about the clouds when we're together? Trails to you till we meet again.
Thank you.
happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep smiling until then. Who cares about the clouds when we're together? Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather. Happy trails to you till we meet again. Who cares about the clouds when we're together?
Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather.
Happy trails.